Hello, everybody. Welcome again. My name is Panos Yuriadis. I'm QA maintenance engineer for SUSE. And today I'm going to talk to you about a personal project of mine that I did during Hack Week that I received a lot of good feedback and interest. So I'm here sharing it with you. The project is called Egkatastasis, which is a Greek name. And most people like, what is this? Like, most people couldn't even pronounce it. The reason I picked a Greek name is because why not? I mean, since I'm in the containers world in testing, everything looks to be Greek there. Even Kubernetes is a Greek word. So I was like, I will use a Greek word. So what a catastasis means for the people who are interested in that, because Marcus asked me before, if we split the word, is actually N, which is in, kata, which is two, and istimi, which is stalum, which is Latin, means like medium. So it's move something into a location or medium, which is install, if you just look at that, and then here is the installation that everybody knows. So Egkatastasis means installation. So my project is about installing something in that case. What it is? I just came up with that. It's an open source project. You can find it in GitHub. And what it does, it's supposed to test packages inside the openSUSE containers that we ship. Okay? How we do that, I use Docker and systemd and spawn. So I use both a process container and a system container. And I use then the Elk stack and the file bit. Well, the whole project is in GitHub. And in case you like this, feel free to contribute to that. And let's see if there is more interest about it. So how it started? About 1 year ago, or even longer, it was Hack Week, and I was checking containers. I was like, what is Docker, what it is? I was learning stuff. So basically, I said, OK, I am an openSUSE guy, so let's use the openSUSE containers. So I go to GitHub, I pull the Docker image we have for Tumbleweed, and I see that we have orphan packages there. Like if you do zipper search in the packets, this package was coming from nowhere. And then I filed the bug, we talked with Martin, we talked with Flavio, and we make it fixed, but it was a bug. Next, we had wrong repositories. After that fix, 3 months later, I download again the new image for openSUSE container, trying to do zipper refresh, and zipper refresh fails because the URL in the repository was wrong. And I was like, what's going wrong? I mean, we have packages coming from nowhere. We have broken repositories. How people, and why I'm the only one that finds those stuff? Like, there was no bug report. So after those, I start looking how I can test it. So I taught a lot of people how I can test containers in openQA. And the feedback I got is that basically you have to boot, you have to install openQA first, and then you have to spawn a virtual machine inside this virtual machine to run a container, which is, looks like too much. Like, it's way more things to be done in that case, and it's really, really slow compared to the typical testing of containers. For those who are interested, since we're in the university here, there is a Google Summer of Code project for that, that people and students are interested to help us and contribute to openQA by investigating a Docker or a container backend in that case. So feel free to check this. So I talked with guys that we do testing. I saw also this, and then I realized that, you know, we actually pushed openSUSE images 1 year ago with no testing them. So I was like, let's try to see how I can test them. That was the motivation behind the whole thing. So the project tries to answer how many packages might be problematic without my knowledge? I mean, I was just lucky when I did zipper search on that specific package, which was Kerberos 5 mini in that case. But can this be that there are also other packages that are broken that I'm not aware of? And if so, how do we know unless I test them all in that case? How many packages are supported in our openSUSE container images? Are the same packages that we support in Tumbleweed, all of them supported also in openSUSE containers? I mean, if I open a bug, would be a legitimate bug, or they would say, no, it's containers, we don't really support it there. And how big undertakings going to be this to test everything? How much time I'm going to take for that, since it's a community-driven project, it's just for fun, learning, experimenting, so I would like not to spend that much of time. How much resources I'm going to need for that, how difficult it's going to be, and how accurate the results are going to be. That was some first questions that I had, okay? So, expectations. The expectations I had is like, this thing has to be fast. What fast means. Fast, definition of fast for me is in that case that I'm going to test the whole ecosystem of openSUSE packages. This means roughly 50,000 packages. I need to test individually 50,000 packages. So in that case, I would say a week would be the maximum for me. I wouldn't wait more than a week to see a result, 5 days or something like that. Trust. Trust means if I find something that is broken in the container, I expect that the same behavior happens in your laptop. If this is not true, my whole project is now it's working. Okay, perfect. Okay. Yes, I was saying that the whole project makes sense only if what I find it's real and it's a bug officially and we have to fix it. Otherwise, if I see different behavior in a container rather than in a laptop, on a desktop, doesn't make sense to do it. And it has to be simple. Simple meaning anybody that wants to contribute, anybody who's not familiar with containers but can jump into it really fast without much knowledge. Requirements for the test environment in that case. I had to build an environment in order to test that. So infrastructure as a code. I needed something that no matter if I'm sitting in my laptop, in my workstation at work, if I visit my friend that has another distribution, I would like not to spend time installing and configuring from scratch and messing up his system. So everything, the whole project is containerized. You just git clone it, run one command, you don't infect your system with any of the things I'm doing. It should be low overhead, meaning like it should be able to scale. If I run it in my laptop, which is a dual core with hyper-threading and 4 gigs of RAM, I should be able to run the whole project in my laptop. And of course, if I move the project into a different infrastructure, which is bigger, 20 cores, more RAM, the project should be able to take advantage of this and be faster, right? And then I needed isolation for exactly what I told you before. Like, I don't want to mess my host system when I'm doing testing in that case. So for isolation, what we have virtual machines that they offer great isolation, but the tooling for making this automatically was a little bit not the easiest, let's say. And as I said before, I would like to have things really easy for that project, like one command things. And also with the virtual machines, I realized that the project is not going to be lightweight. Because if I need to have one packet per virtual machine, this means I need to spawn 50,000 virtual machines. This means I will end up in 2030 in that case. Tzroot, yeah, quite the opposite of what the virtual machine is. Terrible isolation, terrible. So forget this. And I ended up with containers with something in between. They offer okay isolation. The container can see the kernel of your system, can access the hardware resources, but at the same time is not going to mess my host OS packages in that case, only touch the file system of the container. So I ended up with containers also because it was time for me that I was experimenting. The methodology now here. Test shouldn't influence each other. What it means? Back in the day, I was a journalist writing Linux articles and tutorials and guides. And one thing that I really learned is that if you write a guide for somebody to follow, you have to have a clean system, always. If you are going to provide information on the right documentation for somebody, you should make sure that you download the ISO, you boot a virtual machine, you do what you have to do, and these things should be reproducible. So in that case, let's say that we have a test that I have to test packets A. So we spawn a virtual machine in that case, I install packets A. Then if I continue in this system and install packets B, it might be that packets B has a conflict with packets A, but this is not clean anymore because packets A is installed. It should be a virtual machine, packets A. Another virtual machine, packets B. Something like that. So one test, the test for testing packets A, should not interfere with test of packets B. That is the scenario. Test should be ephemeral, meaning like as soon as they run, they get automatically deleted. They don't take space in my machine. They don't use my resources anymore. I don't want to manually take care of removing containers, container images, and other logs of Docker in that case. Tests should not affect the host OS as they are running, what we said before. So this is a screenshot. Yeah, not the best one. I'm using Tmux here, but I can give you a demo later on when I show you better what I'm doing. Here, basically, you see every line you see here, every of these green lines that has success, which means openSUSE rocks in that case, all the packages in that screen is installable, is one container. And this, in that project, here you see, for example, how much time remains until the test is complete. Here you see file bit harvesting for logs and sending them to Egkatastasis. And here I have wrote a really, really hacky parser. Since I'm not aware of any parser for zipper logs, maybe if you are, please let me know. So I just look for errors and I parse for specific strings in the logs to see if they are happening. So the last time I ran that was in January, and I found out that basically 98% of our 64-bit packages we have in openSUSE is super healthy, and only the other percent is not installable. The good thing with that project is that even if a packet can be installed, sometimes we have messages happening in the post-installation scripts. And you can aggregate those and see exactly how many packages share the same messages. And basically, when we release an openSUSE snapshot, if we run this after that, we maybe can say, okay, if we fix this specific bug, 10 or 50 packages is going to be also fixed. So Let me continue. Use cases. Visualization and metrics for the installation of our packages. You can either use the CLI and see the results on the command line, but you can also use Elasticsearch and Kibana and go to your release manager and give him graphs and bars, and I'm sure he will like it. Then I was like, what if openSUSE had a serverless infrastructure that a user, before go to Facebook, Reddit, or openSUSE forums and starts complaining that package A is not working in his machine because he has installed a bunch of custom personal repositories from other people, he can go something like in broken forever, or is just me in that case. So he can just, for the people that were in the previous presentation that I did, he can just send a request with a package, and he can see if this package is installable or not. And if it is and his system is not, then there is something wrong in his system, like he shouldn't file a bug for that in that case. Integration in build service, I'm not sure about that. I'm not very familiar in build service. Actually, I'm not at all familiar with that. I assume that there might be a use case for that. As soon as we build the packets, we can just run this outside of build service in another in infrastructure in order not to cause any overhead in the build service in that case, and have the output in a database. So this can be run also during building in that case. And this is a good entry point for newbies like me in that case, that they want to be maintainers of some packages. When I was volunteering for the Ubuntu Bug Squad, I remember that they had a panel that you can go as a noob basically and say, you know, I want to contribute to this project. I don't want to do translations. I want to write some code and I want to be a maintainer, but I have no idea from where to start. I need some easy tasks. And with this project, since you aggregate all the problems that might happen in the packages, you can classify them as easy things to do, like trivial things to do. And somebody, you can give it, you know, take this and fix it. So there might be a collection of easy to solve problems for the people who are passionate in openSUSE as maintainers. And then we probably can have like a comparison. We can have a live comparison of the status and the quality of the installation of packages in SUSE, Fedora, Ubuntu, Debian, you name it. And you can compare them, and we can also check live what version of packages they have. For example, I see people in forums say, we have the latest GNOME. Or no, we have it. But yeah, but we have this and that. So with this one, if you have all the logs there, you can actually take this information there. You can have a graph and everything. So I will talk a little bit about the future plans that I have with that, and then I will give you a demo. So I will try to put this in Kubernetes to have it in a fast way. Like you have a function, you say test this package gets tested, and I get the result if it's installable or not, along with the log of zipper in that case. Really, really fast. And then I would like to experiment with that, but now that Marcus told me that he doesn't like this, I have to reconsider. Maybe with Kata containers. Kata containers and Google Gvisor would be the thing that I would like to play just for experimentation. This is a fun project. Then I will try to learn a little bit about packaging in build service and see if it makes sense to put it there and how it works. And again, what we said before, entry point for newbies and comparison among other distributions. So I'm basically planning to have a web interface, a website for that thing that you guys visit and you see results. So that's the presentation. Let me give you a demo with that. So what you have to do is clone the repository. The repository, I have already cloned this in that case. So let's go. Here, let me open my browser. So here, if you go to GitHub, I basically have a tutorial MD for the people who would like to try that. And also in the very front page, I have a logo though, so it's professional. You can just go into this folder, Docker, in that case. So we go to, let me zoom. And here there is a bunch of scripts. Let me see, we have how much time we have. Ah, okay, another 10 minutes. So you can do test it. It should be simple, like that. It will not infect your packages. And you put the name of the package that you would like to test. So what's happening in that case? In that case, there is an openSUSE Tumbleweed container downloading in my machine, spawning up, running zipper install vim, as you know, with non-interactive accepting licenses and everything because I can't interact with that. As soon as this finished, it will kill completely the container and remove it from my machine, but it will take the log from zipper and store it locally. As soon as this log is present in my system, FileBit here is going to collect it and send it to Logstash, which is a storage for enterprise logging. Logstash will do some purely idiotic filtering that I'm doing because I don't know any zipper, a parser for that, so I'm just taking the whole thing and it sends it to Elasticsearch. And I have Kibana, which is the web UI for Elasticsearch in case you would like to have some graphs and stuff like that. Ah, perfect. So we see here that Vim is installable right now. That's a live test in Tumbleweed. So if I open, for example, that's interesting, opening Vim with Vim. Yep. You see this is the complete zipper log. So in our openSUSE containers, that's what will happen. Six new packages will be installed, and here is the log of the whole thing. This now goes to Kibana, as I said. So, yes. Here, you can see that FileBit took the file, sent it to Kibana, and I have here the whole log in case I would like to have a central database or have a website, a web server that feeds the content from that database, okay? I think that I have something here that you might like. Yesterday, I ran this in my workstation at work, and I can give you some results for the packages that they are no arts architecture. Unfortunately, the 64-bit packages are about 19,000, and this takes about 1 day and a half. And since I started it yesterday, it's not finished yet. The only thing that got finished is the NoArts packages, that they are roughly 15,000, I think. So I'm going to take this file and put it into my project in that case. And let me unpack it. So now we will see FileBit getting crazy, reading 15,000 logs. This means like since yesterday, I've managed to run 50,000 individual containers with one packet per container, so we know exactly what's going on in our openSUSE Tumbleweed container images in that case. Let me, since this is sending the stuff to the database, let's use the parser to see some stuff here in the terminal. So you see here the timeout. I was a little bit too happy about that, and I was like, okay, I have a 6-core machine at work. Maybe I can run 200 containers at the same time. Yes, I can, but what happened is that my internet connection is not that fast. So basically, I ran into the problem that I have a hard timeout that I don't want to wait forever for a package. There are, might be packages, if we check those packages, because the openSUSE container image is pretty small, there might be that if you try to install one, it will try to install 3 gigabytes of packages. Theo laughs. I know he laughs. So what happened? Internet connection problem. So just some things here. We see that some packages here could not be able to install. So if I do like grep for that, we can see those packages. Python, Django, Network Manager, Novell VPN. This looks like a very old one. Copano Web App, Copana, and stuff like that, GNS. And what is also interesting is from that are installed in that case, I have like 1,500 wrong permissions here, something like this. So if I search for that, I get that. Like setting, blah, 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 trusting wrong permissions. I'm not sure if this is a bug or not, but this is something that I get. This is not a bug. Then why it says wrong permissions? Why there is the word wrong? I mean, you, yes?
Because the permissions file are configuring them. Mm-hmm.
All right. So these are not bugs, that's good to know, but at least what I'm trying to say here is that the parser checks those. In case you need them to check them, the parser checks those. And all those things are now in the database. Hopefully the all things are now here. Let me refresh that. Okay. So yes, everything is here. All the packages. Yeah. And you can go to visualize, create a visualization, create a pie chart, and here you can have your metrics. Like these are all the packages that we have. These are the packages that fail with that error. These are the packages that will fail with the other error, and so on and so forth. So you can say, okay, classify them and give them to your user to fix them. So that's the project so far. It was really fun for me and I received good feedback, so that's why I'm here. Maybe it's interesting for you. You have some ideas to tell me how this can be proved. Any questions? Yeah, let me pass you the microphone, Oliver. This can open like that. There's no battery. Should I try? Ah. Okay.
Yeah, yes. I didn't dare to press the red button on my own. So whenever you submit a package to openSUSE Factory, there's an install check, but of course only for that single package. And of course it could be that it breaks another package that's already there. So maybe these are the errors that you can find with your approach. Yeah. But on the other hand, when we have like a daily Tumbleweed snapshot and you say that this takes like, you know, about a day, mm-hmm. we cannot run this test for every Tumbleweed snapshot. Do you have a suggestion when to do this?
I don't know. Maybe we can run it for lib. I have no idea if it makes sense.
Let him give the chance.
Yeah.
Actually, we spoke about that already in the past. You could only test the packages which changed, and you could talk to RabbitMQ, which is fed by the build service, which packages are changed, and you only need to test those. Mm-hmm. One thing that your regular test would find is packages which fail to build and are now broken because their dependencies changed. So you would still need that regular test like once a week or once every 2 weeks. But if you only want to test in the Tumbleweed timeframe, then test the packages where you get successful build events or publish events.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, we have 1 minute. I would just like to say that this thing works with systemd and spawn container also. So that was another experiment. You can find details how to do it. Any other question in the room? Yes. No. Okay. So no questions. Thank you very much for being here.